episode 151, live.
By the way, we're going.
Are we going?
Sorry.
I
forgot to give you the heads up.
I kind of figured that out. On my own, after 150 episodes, you would, and here we are. Episode 151 from Box O Studio, the shadow of the Great Mountain in Hamilton, Ontario, your source, the very best original music and musicians, each and every week, streaming live on Twitch TV. And, of course, you can find us on YouTube, iTunes, Stitcher Radio, and, as we like to say, Google that shit. Barber, shop, podcast, three words. If you like original music, if you like original people, you're in the right place. Ryan Cannon, Gary Greenland, how you doing?
Excellent.
Good.
Yeah, very good.
It's good. So I see in lieu of Gary getting a mic, you've got a sock
puppet.
Why are you not talking about it? It's off the subject.
It's a special white high-tech voice filtration system.
It's working brilliantly.
Yeah, whatever. I'm not talking.
Yeah, you know what? If they can't find you handsome, that's right. As our good friend Red Green would say. We're playing music, listening to music, and having some stories and some conversation. It's nice to catch up. I have to say, in a big, big way, someone we had been on the show a number of times, and it's a pleasure to get him in on the eve or so of the release of a beautiful record he's taken great pains to put together, and he's brought in J.B. Reed, someone I've worked with a number of times, and just a fantastic musician in her own right, and the two of them are like peanut butter and jelly. It is so good. Duane Rutter, good to have you in the house tonight. How you doing, brother?
Very good. Thanks so much for having us. And which one am I?
Which one am I? You can be peanut butter.
All right.
Good.
Yeah.
I was hoping.
You're feeling like jelly.
I was hoping.
So the music business continues to stupefy, mystify, and keep you going forward, right? Like, tell me how much you love it.
I like it very much.
Yeah. He's been very, very good to me.
Well, I don't know about that.
Yeah.
It's put some hair in my chest.
Yeah. Yeah, you're an interesting character's story. From a preacher, tobacco picker, a badass kid, a street runner, a fighter, and through it all, you know, a troubadour musician. You wrote, you played, your chops are quite legendary, and you've put together a record. And I guess when you get to a certain point in life, you know what you want to do. And you kind of know how you want to do it. Was that the case, or were you kind of just let things happen to a certain extent? Tell me about the evolution where you're like, I'm making a damn record.
Well, started writing the songs that made it to the record a couple of years ago, really. They became what they became fairly recently. To some degree, we did it kind of the old school way. We wrote the songs. I wrote the songs. The people that became my band and I worked them out live, you know, the old way, play them in front of people.
Yeah.
And they evolved that way. And as the chemistry between the players became evident and they turned out to what they are, the chemistry within the people that I'm working with are like nothing I've ever...
There's a real trust that goes on there and a kind of a joy as it flips back and forth, right?
I get such a kick out of, you know, Andrew Aldridge and Steve Wood. Playing off each other, and I look back at them when they're in the middle of something, and they're in their own world together, and it's and they're so good that it's as much, if not more, of a treat for me than the audience. And I've seen people, you know, get up from the back of the room and come up and sit real close or stand real close and watch what they're doing.
Yeah, yeah, it's a beautiful thing when it comes together, and the musicians that you mentioned, you know, some of the best, you know, in the area, and clearly going in and capturing it was part of the deal. And he said, started writing some songs, and of course it develops, and I'm sure stuff, you know, when you start playing with people, you've got a riff, you've got something, you come home late at night or you get up early in the morning, it's stuck in your head. Do you still feel compelled to finish it and bring a finished product to the rest of the band, or are you at the point where it's like, I got part of something?
Yeah, I've never really came to them with part of something.
Yeah.
Pretty much introduced, well, you know, the other thing too is we never really rehearsed. Our gigs were our rehearsals.
Yeah.
And that's a lot to do more than anything with the fact that they're all in such high demand. it's hard to corral them all to for an evening to sit and rehearse. I think we've had maybe two rehearsals, and one of them was just last week.
Yeah. I've had Andrew in here, and one take, you know, beautiful. And he's a, you know, when I've seen you play live, and he's the one beside the PA. Like, I've sat in a bar that's not acoustically friendly with a PA system that's not high end, and that bastard can make it sound like Abbey Road.
Yeah, and when he can't twitch the knobs to make it work, he alters his playing style.
Yes.
And well, no, I wouldn't say maybe not his style, because it's still very much Andrew, but he knows the difference between, he knows nuance better than just about anybody I've ever met.
Yeah, so it's a joy to watch as a guitar player. I watch him all the time.
And me too, man.
That's just part of the fun, coming in and doing that. So we won't get singing too quick right away, because we still got lots of talk. How about JB? How about we talk to you for a second? That's a segue and a half. So the Human Orchestra has just released, or about to release, or releasing and jumping all over a new record.
We did release the actual album. We're about to release it on vinyl.
Yeah, because you do it in stages. You do like a video and a tease and a single. And I like that, because it's in this day and age, you have to, you know, feed the demand. You have to feed what the appetite is.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Well, and it's such a big feat for our band, especially with all the different transitions we've had to go through, to put something out on vinyl. It's like, it's so nostalgic for so many people in our band that it's a big deal to us that we have like a full record. So we like to find as many ways to celebrate it as possible.
Yeah.
So we're like, do this release and then do this interview and then, you know, give this away for free and give this away for cheap and like have a free show. And like, you know, our band really likes to celebrate.
Yeah.
So.
And it's a learning process. The business has changed so much in my watch. You know, I think this is the way things worked at a certain point. And then in the last 20 years, in the last 10 years within that, as soon as you think you got an idea of how the business works, it changes.
Yeah, of course.
So, you know, talk about that, Duane. Like, when you started and you were like, okay, this is how I play music, this is how I get gigs, this is how I get my name out. You know, what was that like in the early days? Like, because you had a place to go. You're a country boy. You dropped in the city with a bunch of clubs.
Well, before I get into that, let me just say, like, the Human Orchestra's new album is like one of my favorite records of all time. And I mean that, there's a big list of favorite records. It's a fantastic record. It's really, really good.
It's a great band.
Now, what were we talking about?
We're talking about you starting the woodshed. Business.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I mean,
coming into the big city.
For the most, for all them buildings.
Jesus Christ.
Lights everywhere. To hell. I've lived in the country most of the time, and it's a major chunk of time just to go get a loaf of bread, for the most part, you know. But in the early days, it was little bars and rough little bars, and it was a lot of driving and hoping that I and learning the songs on the way, you know, because I was a guitar player for people and a bass player for a long time. The city is, and I spent a lot of time in the city as well. But you know, a lot of my family is Toronto people, so as a kid it was nothing. You know, weekends a lot of the time were spent in the city, but a completely different way of life.
Yeah,
a lot more movement than down our way, unless you're in the middle of harvest time or something like that.
Yeah,
scaring up gigs was in the old days was kind of a lot the same as now. I mean, phone calls and following up on phone calls and writing letters.
Yeah,
that sort of thing.
Those were the days. Cursive.
Writing letters. And I used to think, you remember the cartoons where Wile E. Coyote would, you know, he needed something from Acme?
Yeah.
So he puts his money in the mailbox and stands there and then opens the mailbox and there it is?
Yeah.
It wasn't like that.
No.
It
wasn't like that. That's always such a great disappointment. Let's jump ahead to 2015. And we're looking at, you know, a date of October 10th.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a Saturday night at the Casbah.
Mm-hmm.
This be the Wednesday. This be the 7th. So for the people watching in the future, 3 days before release of this CD. Okay. Crazy things. You have something like dyed up in this because it's a polished jewel. I mean, you took your, you know, you've talked a bit about the band you work with, mm-hmm. and you got to go in probably Hamilton's number one studio, Grant Avenue, and record in there. Tell me, the band was very tight. You were working your hard. So, I mean, you were in mm-hmm. there. The band was tight. You were obviously efficient. Any surprises or like what coming out of it? A lot of times it's really tenuous and difficult to get the product. It seemed like it kind of flowed well for you.
It did. First off, back in May, I went down to Rhinebeck, New York to record with Garth Hudson and his wife Maud, sister Maud. And we just did that, the three of us. So we laid down a whole bunch of tracks, just the three of us. I laid down the beds and the vocal and guitar for most of the record, which we didn't use. We used the Garth and Maud tracks, bringing those back and making them work was probably, you know, I can't speak for Andrew, but I would say that was probably the toughest part because Garth records, he had set himself up in a little fort of keyboards and everything was running on a separate line. And so it wasn't, I'll do an organ track and yeah. now I'll do a piano track. And now it was all at the same time. He'd be here and then he'd be there and then he'd be there, but it was all recorded at the same time. Yeah. So what we ended up with was a big bag of files.
Yeah.
They were all labeled at the studio at the time and Garth would come back in after a take and he could see, it was done on Pro Tools down there and he could see from where he was sitting. He had them enlarge the screen. Yeah. In the control room, and then he'd go, get rid of that, cut that, fade that one out, pan this one, back, number 1, 6, 3, 4, back to there, no, 3, 4, you know? Yeah. And he did a lot of his own edits right then and there, which mind-boggled me because I just did this, screen, Garth, screen, Garth, screen, Garth. It made the job, and Paul Antonell was the recording engineer down there, he owns the studio, and he's recorded Carly Simon and the B-52s and Living Color was just there the day before I was there, and huge choruses and Pete Seeger's stuff was done there, and so he knew what he was doing and was gracious enough to make sure that when I left with the files, they were all labeled and easy for Andrew to read. We brought the files back, and the first time I had a look at the files, I still couldn't understand.
Yeah.
but Andrew knew what was going
Andrew,
on.
Andrew, yeah, one wonderful engineer and producer in his own right. Yeah, and yeah.
So that was the biggest, really the biggest hurdle was putting that stuff together and then syncing it up. The longest track was done live with no click. And so the time, it lived and breathed as we did it. And it's very spooky and it was dark. It was 6:30 in the morning and we'd been up all night and for a couple of days and slept very little. And what we got back was on Take That Water was a very scary sounding song. And that was before anything was added.
Yeah. Wow. Looking forward to this, as you should. If you can, there's probably still a few tickets left, if you're lucky. Get yourself up and get some tickets for the Casbah this Saturday night. We're going to hear some in a bit, but we always like kicking off with some live music. We're big promoters of live music on this show. As great as a recording is, it's to see someone live and to see a human and to feel the interaction and the give and take in a room. It's a different game altogether. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like watching something and doing something. Mm-hmm. And in this case, we're pleased to bring some live music. You know, the voice of J.B. Reed. What are you going to kick off with tonight?
I think we'll start with Who Found Who. Got nothing much to say about it.
It's a kick-ass song.
Less said the better, probably.
Yeah, well, you're going to hear it right now at barbershoppodcast.com.
You all set, J.B. Reed?
Yeah.
I'm peanut butter, right?
Okay.
It
It's a slippery slope we climb. I'm slipping all the time. They don't pay no mind, they don't care about us. That's okay, I guess. In fact, it's for the best. So you just get some rest. Let me drive the bus. Let's put some road behind us. Some place where they can't find us. Oh, hell, I don't care if they do. 'Cause you've got stars around you. That I was the one who found you. In case you wonder who found who. Well, I found. I had a dream last night. We were loose and tight. And even the shame felt right. Now don't that just be all? But now I'm fast awake. And we've got plans to make. For just one lucky break before we face a fall. Let's put some road behind us, some place where they can't find us. Oh, hell, I don't care if they do. 'Cause you've got stars around you, but I was the one who found you. In case you wonder. This ain't for the faint of heart. Hold on tight or fall apart.
Duane Rutter with J.B. Reed, your Barbershop Podcast, and we bring it to you every week without fail. And I want to give a shout-out to our sponsors, this sponsor in particular, that would be hamiltonartist.ca. If you want something printed on something, and eventually you're going to, be it something small or something medium-sized or perhaps even something really large, like wrapping a vehicle, you want to design something, you want to get your brand or your band out there, go check them out, hamiltonartist.ca. They're at 1141 Main Street East at Balmoral in Hamilton. That's just east of the Delta. You can be part of their online community, create your own orders, ask about member discounts. They've got candles and jewelry and clothing, and you should go visit them. That's hamiltonartists.ca. All right, we got Duane Rutter in the studio, and he is singing and playing, and we're talking a little bit about Crazy Things. And this is the new offering from Duane Rutter. He's got a great crew. Fantastic. I'm looking to dig into this, so I'm not gonna gab anymore. Gary, I think we should just do it right here. Don't forget, barbershoppodcast.com. Trippy. Trippy. Gotta like it right there. Crazy Things. You can look forward to grabbing a copy of this record this Saturday. That'd be October 10th at the Casbah Lounge, corner of King and Queen Street in Hamilton, Ontario. One of Hamilton's premier destinations. If not the premier destination, I got a lot of friends, I can't say that. But it's a good place. Always been treated good there by Brody. They got craft beer and they got great sound. Good people right there. Saturday night, October 10th. Go check it out. $20 you get yourself in the door and you get a CD. What's the dealio?
Yes, sir. Yeah, $20 you get the CD.
And the show.
And the show.
And the show is worth $20 on its own, and the CD's worth $20 on its own. So you got to go. All right. This Saturday night, it's going to rock and roll with the country roots blues stylings of Mr. Duane Rutter. I guess a lot of people have asked you, like, what do you play? And we talked about this before, Canadiana. You know, Americana. Yeah.
North Americana.
Yeah. Something about roots and boots and people and aches and pains. Mm-hmm. And putting it down to something that I always said, you know, rhythmic enough men can drink to it and women can dance to it. You know, mm-hmm. Got to have a little bum shake to it. You certainly know that part, right?
Yeah, I've shaken my bum at least six times in the last 40 years.
I guess this week you shake your butt a lot. You've been running here, there, and everywhere doing press.
Doing the work, man.
You're doing the work to get it out. It is a constant job. We like helping out here at Barbershop Podcast. And I'm sure this record will be available on iTunes or...
It's available now for pre-order.
Pre-order. Get in there. Get in there while it's going good. All right, we're going to do another live tune because that's what we do. We're going to start ramping up the music. Less barber chatter. And more ruddering.
Look that up.
Look that up.
And you'll really want to come to the show.
Yeah, good times.
That's the title song. It's called the title song, Crazy Things.
Well, she drew her hand right across my face, and she blew my mind into outer space, and she kissed my cheek, and she rubbed my neck, and said your better days haven't happened. Thank you. Could have called her name, but my throat was dry, and the only water here is in these tired old eyes. So I packed my bags, threw them in my truck. I didn't lock the door, I left a couple.
Crazy Things, the title track from Duane Rutter, and he has a new release, album of the same name. I still call them albums, I call them records. They are, in fact, songs and stories. Crazy Things from Duane Rutter, in here with J.B. Reed. We are listening to the music live, and otherwise, we've got a sample from the CD, soon to be released. Get yourself a taste of it. Get down to the Casbah this Saturday night, the 10th of October. If you're watching now, live on Twitch TV, or in the next couple days, or get yourself one on iTunes, pre-order it. Yeah, love it. We're going to get another sample of it. Gotta love it. Thick, luxurious sounds. Can't go wrong. We're going to play Will I Ever Learn? Something I've asked myself a number of times. We won't talk about the six creamsicles, you know. Brother. I want to hear it. Can I hear it?
Yeah.
All right.
Whip it out, Edgar.
Let's whip it out right now. Will I Ever Learn? Duane Rutter. Crazy Things at barbershoppodcast.com.
Happy not to
Will I Ever Learn from barbershoppodcast.com each and every Wednesday on Twitch TV. We got Duane Rutter and JB Reed in the house tonight, and they're singing and they're playing, and it's a great CD that's come out, Crazy Things. You just heard Will I Ever Learn. You can check them out this Saturday night at the Casbah Lounge, where you can get yourself a copy. Do that. It's nice to have a piece of physical copy, a WAV file, especially something that sounds this fancy. All right. I'm going to give a shout out to our other great sponsor, Disc Runner. We put stuff on stuff whenever we need to press it and get it out there. Disc Runner, they've done very good by us. Price, quality, service. If you want to get something, any of your media needs, anything disc worthy, they offer a wide variety of services: duplicating, replicating, mastering, glass masters, print and packaging, web design, social media, all disc formats available to direct CD, DVD, Blu-ray, you name it. DiscRunner.com. Tell them Kevin sent you. We've got Duane Rutter, JB Reed in the house. We're talking about Crazy Things. We're talking about the record. We're talking about the business. It can get crazy sometimes. It can be the best thing. It can be the worst thing. How do you maintain your vitality and your strength? Because it's something that's, you know, sucked the life out of some young people. And I guess you just use your sage wits after a while. How do you manage to keep up? Because you've just been driving this train.
I've been driving this train real hard for a year. And that's a lot of what the record's about. It's you know, I've got that tag, go ahead and tell me what I can't do.
Yeah.
Which has caught on nationwide, I might say. There's people, a woman out on the West Coast who bought a whole bunch of go ahead and tell me what I can't do mugs from our sponsor.
Yeah.
And because she looks after chronic care and people, and this she found that just the tagline was inspirational.
Yeah.
And so have other people. I've got people send me pictures of that.
Yeah,
you know, and they've ordered T-shirts with it and all that kind of stuff, and really that's a driver, you know. I mean, I'm a lot more mellow these days on the outside than I appear on the inside. Trust me.
Yeah,
but it's perpetual motion.
Yeah, it has to be, and I've often said that to have a parent or someone responding to a growth or an attempt to do something. To pat someone on the head and say, yeah, that's great, and really feel it's crap, you're further ahead to tell the person you think it's crap, because then it gives them motivation. There's nothing better than having something that somebody considers an impossible dream, you know? How dare you assume that you can afford a life in music? And I see it every week, the talent that comes in here. And, well, you know, we watched a whole bunch of videos that we used to shot. That was a great band. 6 months. That was a great band. 9 months. That was a great band. They made it 11 months. And to keep going and keep doing it, that's, you know, like...
I'm too far in it now to give up, you know. Yeah. I just turned
52. Too deep in the woods.
I've been doing it since I was 14. And, you know, we had some up and down years there and a lot of wasted time. And, you know, I mean, I'm young. I'm 52 is young. But I'm not 22.
Yeah.
And my time is limited.
You pick your shots
now. I'm on the other
now.
Side of the hill going down. So I've got a lot of time to make up for. And a big driving factor to work so hard for this record and to push it is, you know, I had crowdfunding that helped me out with it a little bit. A great deal, actually. And I've got people working with me that have put their heart in it. JB's been at so many shows singing with me. It means so much to me. Everybody that's worked with me and supported me means so much to me that I can't let them down. I won't let them down, and I want to do something that'll make them proud, And if this record, it's already been played around the world. It hasn't been released yet. And if that can draw some attention to this, the plethora of talent in the Hamilton
and
area,
surrounding areas, yeah.
You can't swing a dead cat without hitting a real great player, you know.
Yeah.
And I've swung a few dead cats in my
life.
Like I say, I mean, a lot of the driving force is to just make it, let the people that count on me or that have supported me know that I support them, and I'll do whatever it takes. I'll knock on doors and I'll crawl across cut glass to get this record out there.
Yep, and that's it. This is where the fun starts. This is where you take this baby and you put it in the army and you make it serve mankind.
It won't be because I didn't do the work.
Yeah.
I mean, at least I can go to bed at night saying I don't know what else I could have done.
Yeah. This record will not have daddy issues. It is loved and supported. All right, we got Duane Rutter and JB Reed in the studio. We're listening to music live and otherwise. We're going to do another live one right now because that's what we do. That's what you do. Duane Rutter, great guitar picker, great vocalist, singer-songwriter, blending voices with JB Reed, real treat in the studio. What's the, you got to want to talk about this song or is it self-explanatory? I like that. All right, I'm going to slide you into it like we do with my formal introduction. Duane Rutter, right here, barbershoppodcast.com.
You're the one.
one I need. You're the one who told me to figure out why there's no cuts where I bleed.
That's The Cat, Duane Rutter's song, given to you right here in the flesh. Barbershop Podcast. It's nothing like wood and steel and voices coming together. Remind you of the simplicity, what makes a good song. It's nice to flesh one out, but the bare bones of a song, when you know it's good, you feel it, right? Are you tough on yourself as a editing your own stuff and evaluating your own stuff and what's ready to go to?
I'm excruciatingly tough on myself. In my songs, in my life, I'm pretty tough on myself. Some of the songs just come, though, and I don't edit much. Sometimes when I'm real lucky, it all just kind of comes into the antenna and filters through, and I don't do a hell of a lot but write it down. Because I know that it all means something. And just because I'm not conscious of the thought at the time or what the thought is, something speaks.
Yeah, and it reveals itself later quite often.
It reveals
often.
And sometimes they reveal themselves quite a while later.
Yeah.
Most of these songs were like that. I mean, they started off one way from a completely different place than where I see them now.
Yeah.
And
that's the beauty to me of songwriting. That's how someone can take something so personal and have it so universal, and you start seeing this cosmic Buddhist understanding that it's all connected and it's all over, you know, and to bring the message and to have someone feel. That's why when you listen to a song, you actually feel things, you know, you feel
it
goosebumps.
That's one thing. You can have an issue or you can have something that's going on in your life or in your heart. And, you know, if it's a grieving process or whatever process, that takes time. I mean, time wounds all heals, as they say. But if I can get it condensed, it speeds up the healing process, speeds up time, because it becomes something tangible.
Yeah.
And hopefully it becomes something else. It comes to mean something else. I certainly know that with number one, for instance, the first time JB sang it at the staircase, that song became something completely different than what it was when it was written. And that sped time up for me.
Yeah.
Exponentially.
Well put. Nicely put. We're talking about music, its effect, something that's psychological and physiologically imperative to humanity and mankind. And you can't have the processed crap. You need the good stuff, the fresh, the farm fresh stuff. And that's what we bring.
Farm fresh
music. And we bring it here. It is good stuff. Duane Rutter. Got Crazy Things, the name of a CD. It's coming out this Saturday officially at the Casbah. You got to go to Hamilton, Ontario. Check out the Casbah at the corner of King and Queen Street in Hamilton, Ontario.
Got to speak about my opening acts on the show,
yes,
too.
Yes, please do.
Yeah, I've got Sharon Washington. Yeah. Sharon did the layout, the design, the concept for the artwork. Her business is Bond Street Design. She did a fantastic job. She's also a renowned songwriter, and she's becoming a singer-songwriter in her own right these days.
Yeah, she's taking her time on those beautiful songs, but everybody's waiting.
Everybody's waiting. Yeah, she's a wonderful soul and a great artist. And so she's doing a set with Scott Backler and I believe Mike Berthomer might be joining her as well. And Chris Altman's going to do a set.
Yeah.
I'm real curious. I'm looking forward to that, to both of them. And I got an email from Chris today, a Facebook message. You know, I put the word out, what do you guys bring in? What kind of a backline do you need, whatever? And Chris is bringing an electric guitar.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's what he's bringing to the podcast next week, too.
Is that right?
Yeah, next week's guest, Chris Altman.
Yeah, I'm real excited to have him.
Australian expatriate.
Yeah.
Love him. What a great guy. The community, it's so full of good people. When someone is earnest and steadfast, and they're, as you said, you can't swing a cat without hitting a great player as a songwriter. You go hard, because you'll find someone. If you've got something in your head that you need to flesh out, you'll find it. You know, here in Hamilton, what a great city full of great musicians. We're going to hear another track off of Crazy Things. We're going to play it, and I bet it is good, but the song is Ain't No Good. We're going to hear it right here, right now, barbershoppodcast.com.
Well, I woke up with no song in my head. First time since I was 9 or 10. I couldn't tell the whispers from the wind. Just want to close my eyes again. Everything kept running through my mind. Knocking over things she left behind. To hit the ground, to turn to dust and smoke. I shouldn't have left them where they could get broke. I ain't no good. I ain't no good. Still, I made myself get up and walk around. Scraped a couple shadows off the ground. Tore him up, threw him out the door, and put him back together on the floor. 'Cause I ain't no good. I ain't no good. I ain't no one's little darling, ain't no one's candy heart. I wouldn't want it if I could, 'cause I ain't no good. I ain't no good. Well, there are to be a law for men like me, who hang their hearts on every tree. 10 years for weighing down the limbs, 10 more for doing it again. 'Cause I ain't no good. I ain't no good. Thank you.
Ain't No Good featuring the sweet honey bear himself, the dulcimer tones, Mr. Steve Wood, yeah. Pedal Steel, killer band. Let's mention some of the other people in the band. People have been playing with you for a while.
Yeah, Carrie Ashworth is on the record, and she's another busy one.
Yep.
Playing with everybody. Yeah, she's on the record. She'll be in the show Saturday night. Nick Burson,
yep.
HMA Drummer of the Year.
Yep, and rightfully so. He's on everything, and he's great at everything. So.
Well, Nick has got a particular quirky style that's you listen to the record. Every time I hear it, I hear something a little different that he's done, some little something. It's really quite part of the sound of the band, just as much as Andrew's sonic soundscapes and Steve Honeyboy's heartbreaking dulcimer tones. Mm-hmm. And Carrie's bass. Carrie's bass on the record really is prominent.
Stand out.
Well, I had Nick Blagona mix the thing and master it. And, you know, Nick doesn't make quiet records.
No.
Deep Purple and, you know.
So many great ones.
So many great
Saturday
ones.
Saturday Night Fever. Like,
Saturday Night
that
Fever.
Had bass in it.
Yeah. So, I mean, I didn't go in there to make a record that was, a passive statement. And everybody just dug their heels in. It was amazing. And even Amy King plays some banjo on one of the songs and does some shaker work. And, Mark LaLama on the record. But and JB, of course, on several cuts and duets on the title track. Lisa Wynn on Will I Ever Learn. It
goes on and on and on.
They're just great people and great artists. I sound like I'm gushing about them, but I'm just really sincerely thrilled to have them in my world.
It's something to be proud of, and it's nice. We put so much work into it, so much faith into it, and it comes out, and you hold that child up, and it's a beautiful thing. Mm-hmm. And this is what we've got right here. We're going to get one more live song. We're going to play one more off the CD before we say goodnight. So what have you got?
Well, we recorded, Garth and Maud and I recorded three songs down there. Two of them are on the record. The last one is a relatively new song. We're going to try and release it as a 45, perhaps, something as soon as we can. We want to give the record a little bit of time to breathe and then hit them with this one. There's some great parts on this record. That was the first one Garth put his parts on, the first time in the studio when he was done setting up and he was playing along. That I went, there it is. That's
a sound,
right? And Maud worked really hard on that one as well. So it's not on the record, but I'd love to do it. It's one of my favorites.
Well, we would love you to do it. We're gonna hear it right here, right now, at barbershoppodcast.com.
Just holding on. I was just so I drove down south to steal a little shine off the Florida Keys. I hit the 7-mile bridge and I shut my mouth, and I didn't say a word for the next 3 weeks. She was a blister on a dead man's tongue, kind that you get from the cold hot steel. She was a reason for the midnight run. She was a bullet that you just can't feel. And I was just lonely. I was looking for a light in the dark. I was just hoping that she was the one. Wish I never would have promised to toe that line. Wish I never would have wanted what could never be mine. I was just lonely. I was just holding on. I was just looking for a light in the dark. I was just hoping. I was just lonely. I was just holding on. I was just looking for a light in the dark. I was just.
Duane Rutter, right here at Barbershop Podcast with the fantabulous J.B. Reed. What a wonderful song. That is a winner indeed. I certainly hope you do put that out as a 45.
I'll give you a little secret. It's the encore song on Saturday night.
There you go. You're going to get to hear it. And the encore song, it's going to be, everything's going to be vibrating and colorful at that point. It's a great thing when you go to a CD release and you see it. Like I'm always, it's like a baptism or a wedding, or it's the culmination of something, and it's a celebration of something, and it's a beautiful thing. It's a crazy
our shows
thing.
Have been like that, like right from the get go. You know, when we started kind of putting the thing together down at the Cat and Fiddle, for instance, you might have been around
in
some of those
in a day,
and. There was just, you know, we packed the place, and it was just such a feeling of joy, almost, you know, to sound kind of corny. When we did The Staircase and packed The Staircase, those songs were all new, and the band had never heard them before. Nobody had heard them at me.
Yeah.
And we played them live to a full house.
Yep.
My record label guy, Mark Logan, said, "You're doing what?" This is what we're doing.
Yep.
And there was just, you know, the house lights came on for the last few songs, and it was, you know, I heard about that for weeks and weeks. It was just such a great time, and nothing could be better for me.
Yeah, it's fantastic. Experience live music. Experience this show Saturday night, October 10th at the Casbah, corner of King and Queen Street in Hamilton, Ontario. Duane Rutter is our guest. J.B. Reed is his guest and our guest, too. It's a double whammy. We're going to hear one more off of this great CD, and take that water. Take it here. Take it now. BarbershopPodcast.com.
Big
get down to the field. Dig down water, dig it down to the field. Better give them boys a break. Tell them it ain't no big deal. Tell them that the boss has got a heart. Boss can feel. Where were you last night? You know I waited all night long. Where were you last night, baby? You know I waited all night long. Just howling at the moon, thought you might like to come along. You were just exercising your free will. Ain't done nothing wrong. Steel. Got a big bad heart. Been drunk cold as polished steel.
Took a little while to realize that my soul was just your me.
Have you seen my horses? Something spooked, that's for sure. Have you seen my horses? Something spooked, that's for sure. Might have been a coyote, I don't know. Everything's just a blur. Don't you spook my horses. You're gonna get what you deserve. Love you, one Garth.
Dig down water. The sun is hot, they must be dry. Dig down water. The sun is hot, they must be dry. Such a dreadful sky. You know, if it was me, I'd have said long ago, sorry, boss, goodbye. Dig that water, dig it down to the field.
Is Garth Hudson. If you've ever seen The Last Waltz and seen the kind of crew that was on that stage that night, any of the incredible library of the band, and that's the man playing with Duane Rutter on Crazy Things. Something in his head, the tape was rolling, magic and history was made. Well, you went to Grunhall, you went to Texas, and you did it big down there. You're going to the Bluebird in Nashville. I want to wish you good luck with that.
Thank you very much.
Take it on the road. Duane Rutter.
Thanks
Don't
for having me.
Tell him what he can't do. Get on the Duane train. It'll be a station near you. Until next week, for Ryan Cannon, Gary Greenland, and all of you good people there, Thanks for coming out. See you next week. BarbershopPodcast.com.